Hello. How have you been? Thank you for joining us again in this course, Food and Beverage Cost Control. This is the second chapter, which is about daily food cost or monthly food cost. How do we get these costs? How do we get daily food cost and monthly food cost? Of course, it is very simple. What I want you is to what I want is to follow and ask questions if you want. It's about daily and monthly food cost. I give you a warm welcome once again. I hope you will much benefit from these courses. Remember, some of our objectives is that at least at the end of this course, we are able to be good food and beverage cost controllers. And when we are good cost controllers, we mean that we work to minimize cost but maximize profit, of which most of the organizations like. They want to work under a minimum cost but high profit. Very important. Well, at the end of this chapter, you'll be able to identify formulas, and also we shall look at factors that causes variations in the food cost. We shall also be able to see how to get the daily food cost and monthly food cost, even how you can report. How the report looks like and what the elements or the concepts of the daily report or monthly report. So when we talk about daily food cost, why do we need to calculate daily food cost? Why do we keep on getting or calculating? Why do we stress ourselves daily calculating food cost? Why? Why can't we wait for a certain period? Then we get the food cost. Wow. One is that it cannot reveal any problem promptly and correct actions also cannot be taken promptly. If you don't calculate the cost on a daily basis, food cost on a daily basis, so you will not realize problems early. So problems may not be realized and corrected in the right time. So that's why we do calculate food cost on a daily basis, so that if we see that today we made a mistake and our cost raised, at least tomorrow we are able to take a corrective measure or action. So to avoid this delay, to avoid these mistakes or problems, we must make a daily food cost. This will help managers identify situations promptly and we react on them before they have much effect in our their business. So managers do make their reports or do receive their reports, do require cost controllers or F&B managers or chefs to give cost reports on a daily basis only because they want them. They want to avoid any delay in terms of taking corrective measures in case there is any problem. And it will also help them to know how the business, how the hotel is functioning. Is he meeting its target? Is he meeting its goals? So the daily food cost is very, very, very important because you cannot be able to know whether you are having high cost or low cost without producing a daily food cost. So if today you got a high food cost, a high cost, at least you work better to minimize it tomorrow. So daily food cost is very, very important. How do you get daily food cost? Daily issues are always equal to daily food cost. That is in the stock. In the stock, when they are going to produce the daily food cost, they will take all the daily issues and they will consider those daily issues as if they are equal to food cost. But remember, not all daily issues are used to are used immediately after being received or taken to the production areas. Sometimes you may request items and you take them in the production area expecting guests, but you don't get them. So even if you got your items from the store, but sometimes if the chef calculates his own food cost by not considering the cost of issues, you will have different food cost. We shall see it. Therefore, daily food cost is equal to direct issues plus storeroom issues. When you talk about daily issues, these are perishable items that do not keep in the storerooms. They go direct to the production areas as immediately as they are received. So after receiving them, they go direct to the production areas. For example, you can say vegetables and fruits and dairy products. All these items, we don't keep them in the stores. They are called direct issues. They are recommended to be ordered on a daily basis. So if we receive vegetables and fruits today, we are expecting to receive more tomorrow. So no need of keeping them in the store. Since they are to be used on that particular day, they go direct to the production areas. That's why for you to get the daily issues, which is food cost, you get direct issues plus storeroom issues. And if it is monthly issues or monthly food cost, we take opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock. This is on the monthly issues, which is monthly food cost. For it, at the end of the month, you will not say, yeah, I will take direct issues. No, that cannot apply. You will take the opening stock, which is the closing stock of the previous month. You add purchases that you got or you did from the first of the month, the first day of the month, until the end, the last day of the month. So all those purchases you did in between are added to the opening stock, then you minus the closing stock of that particular month. Hope it is clear. Therefore, we can say that food cost is equal to opening food cost, but at the end of the month, though this formula can also be used on a daily basis. You can also still say that yesterday I did my inventory. So the inventory you did yesterday, the value of the stock I had yesterday, it was the closing stock. So today it must be opening stock or opening inventory. So you can use this formula even on a daily basis, whereby we take opening stock plus purchases and you minus ending or closing stock or inventory. But when you want to calculate the food cost in terms of percentage, you will multiply by 100 but divide by total sales. You will take the food cost, because opening stock plus purchases minus ending stock is what is food cost. So their food cost is 100 over total sales. It gives food cost percent. Wow. These are the same stories. These are the same stories. But I want to go to how you, do you get purchases? So purchases are calculated. It is the summation all of all delivered invoices during that particular period. We will check all the invoices you received is what we call purchases. All items you received, of course, those are the items, those are called purchases. So, the closing stock is the value of stock at the end of the month. It's always 30th or 21st of each and every month, you must go, you must do inventory. You must check all value your stock before you start another month. The opening stock will be the closing stock of the previous month. Therefore, the cost of sales, which is food cost, is going to be beginning of opening inventory plus purchases minus closing inventory cost. But as I said, you may be having the cost of food, the cost of food issued, which is we say is equal to food cost, but it is not equal to the cost of food consumed. Sometimes we do make transfers to other areas, to other kitchen. For example, like a hotel that has got more than one kitchen. Sometimes one kitchen may order items and get may order some items from the store, but also order some other items from another outlet, either from bar, either from another kitchen. So they may share raw materials. So whichever raw material a certain kitchen took from your kitchen is going to be minus, is going to be deducted from your cost of food issued. If you have the amount equivalent to the cost of food issued, then you will add all transfers you got from other people. If there are any transfer you got from a certain department or a certain outlet, you are going to add it, like cooking spirits or cooking liquors, cooking wines. If you got them from bar, you must add them because they must be under your cost. Transfers from other units. For example, you are getting maybe Irish potatoes from a certain kitchen. So though you did not get them from the store, but they must be added to your account as a cost to your kitchen. Food you got from bar. Food you took to bars or food taken by people who work in bar. So they have taken them from your kitchen. So those ones are going to be deducted. Though you requested them from the dry store or to the store, and they are recorded under your cost, but you did not use them, they are taken by other people. If they are taken by other people from another department, so they must not be you under your cost. You are going to minus them. Any transfer that goes from your kitchen to another area, to another section, to another department, it is minus. It is deducted from your cost. But add them in another account in their department. Grease sales. If you incurred grease sales, it means they did not give you any money. You produced a certain dish, for example, but it was not sold. You will not consider its cost since it was not sold. Steward sales. So those are the food that you sell, but you give them maybe because of a certain activity, maybe to our employees, they were engaged in some activities, and then they missed lunch for their staff, together with their staff. They did not share lunch, for example, together with their staff, with other staff, because they were engaged in other activities. And then you decided to give them food from the budget of guests, or from food of guests, food prepared for guests, for example, or food which must be prepared only for guests, because you ordered them under the account of your kitchen operation. So you must remove them. You must deduct its amount or its cost. Gratis to bar. Those items given to bar, like cookies, nuts, so their cost must be deducted. Promotional expenses. If you give one free to any person who buys two items, for example, if one person consumes maybe 5 bottles of wine, takes 5 bottles of wine, and you decide to give him a glass of wine free, that is a promotion expense. So it is also minus. If then the total that you are going to get is what we call cost of food consumed. So food cost or cost of food consumed. It is what you will get after minusing, after removing all the transfers that you did to other areas. Sorry. Now, how do you get the cost of food sold? If you get the cost of food consumed and you minus cost of meals of employees, you will get what we call cost of food sold. If you don't share the kitchen with staff, means the cost of employees' meal will be zero. So the cost of food consumed will be equal to cost of food sold, but they are not always equal. Sometimes you may find a hotel or a kitchen whereby meals also meal staff meals are also prepared to they don't have a separate budget from the budget of employees or guest food or meals. Wow. Next. Inventory stock turnover. For you to get what we call inventory stock, all stock turnover, it is the way we compute or we get or we evaluate the organization, how the organization sells stock within a given period of time. If you delay your stock, if at all the stock that you have, items are not moving, it will be indicated by what we call inventory turnover. So inventory turnover is equal to the cost of goods sold over average inventory. Average inventory. So you take the total cost of goods sold or food sold divided by average inventory, like this one. The total cost of sales was 1 million, and the opening inventory was that one, or 3 million, and closing inventory was 4 million. Therefore, average or inventory turnover is given by taking the cost of food consumed, or the cost of food sold, divided by the summation or the average of the inventory. So you take two inventories, you add them, multiply. You divide by the number of their inventory, the number of inventories, which is always two. Because we do have two inventories. One is opening, another one is closing. So daily report. After making daily food cost, after observing and computing daily food cost, you must give a report. And this report, we have these components. We'll have food cost, food sales, food cost percent, and also break down how the food cost amounts, how what raised the food cost, or what made the food cost to be, for example, 20%. Why was food cost 20%? We'll indicate by showing total direct issues and storeroom issues, the amount. Causes of high food cost. Why do we have a high food cost sometimes? An increase in the cost of the item without a corresponding increment in the price. So, for example, we are selling, you had inyanya juices on your menu. And you wanted to sell it. Unfortunately, you may find that inyanya raised its price of fresh juice. So if the juice is now changed in prices and it was raised, but and you did not raise or change the price of that particular juice, you are risking of having high food cost because you are spending more but charging less. Poor portion control. An increase in the size of the portion served would increase percentage cost. If you are supposed to give 500 milliliters and you are giving 600 or 800 or 200, it means you are not consistent. You are not giving the right measurements to the guests. One of the consequences is that, or one of the effects is that if you give less, you will not get customers. If you give more, you will make losses. So you must follow standard set. Wastages through bad purchasing, poor preparation, or incompetent cooking. You did not purchase properly. The amount that was on the invoice was not correct. The quantities that you received are not the ones written on the invoice. So those differences may lead to increment in the food cost. Bad pricing policy. If you don't know how to price, you may find yourself that you are having high food cost without knowing. So you must have pricing knowledge or good pricing methods. Poor menu planning. If you are not a good menu planner, and you put two expensive items only on your menu, so you will not be able to control your cost, will be high, inaccurate forecasting. You were expecting a big number of customers and you prepared everything, but there comes a small number of customers. It means those food will end up raising your cost, and yet there are no sales for them. There is no sale related to those items. That is the end of our presentation. And if you get a question, you will WhatsApp me to the number we show on the screen. You may WhatsApp on the number shown on the screen if you want to ask any question. And then I'm always available to answer you. Then let's do some few exercises before we move to the next chapter. Let's look at this activity to be activity to one. Let's look at some activities. Those ones are, we said there is one we should start with, which is number 8, exercise number 8, and says on 31st October, Epic Hotel built its talk, and it was that one, 21st October. During the same month, it made the following purchases. 31st October, and in the same month of October, they had purchased the following items. Now we are being to calculate the cost of sales for that month. And the closing stock, they said that it is 100,000 closing stock of the month of September. If it was 100,000, so it became the opening stock of the next month, which was October. It means 100,000 is opening stock, while 200,000 are closing stock for the month of October. Therefore, the cost of sales for the month of October, you will take total purchases. If they purchase 2 boxes of Nyanja water at 15,000 per box, they purchased 20 kilograms of rice at 1,500 francs. So for you to get the cost percent, you must take opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock, and purchases you are able to find them here. You are able to add all the purchases this hotel did. Then we find cost as a percentage of sales. If sales were 1 million, very simple. Wow. Let's also share with you another question, but I want you to make it as, want you to do it as, I want you to do it as, yes. Well, there is another exercise I would like you to think about, and see whether you can try it. This is about calculating the cost of food issued, which is the food cost, whereby we are given, we are told that on 1st January 2021, Lemigo Hotel purchased items as they are shown in the table below. Sugar, 50 kilograms, tomato paste, 30 tins, 15 bottles of soy sauce, 10 packets of chocolate blocks, 15 tins of black olives, etc. And we have frozen items, minced meat, lapia, Parmesan cheese, 5 pieces, etc. We have dairy items and vegetables. Remember what we said about direct issues and storeroom issues. So storeroom issues and direct issues are the only ones, are those I those that is that secret, the secret that I mentioned is the one that is going to help you for you to know the daily food cost. Yeah. Those are the vegetables that he received on that day. If on the same day they only issued sugar 10 kilograms, remember they received 20, 50 kilograms, but they are issuing 10. They received almost, I think, 15 tomato paste tins, but they are issuing 2. It means the, though they purchased in bulk dry stock, they are not going to use them all in one day. So that's why they must consider the cost of only items which you issued on that particular day. Calculate the food cost for that day. If you purchase those items, if you issued these items, what would be the cost for that day? We are also asked B to calculate the cost of food consumed. We are to calculate the cost of food consumed on that day. If production area got one Parmesan cheese as a transfer from other kitchen, you received a transfer of Parmesan cheese, which is one, and you gave out 10 kilograms of Irish potatoes to another kitchen, but you bought 250 milliliters of, which is a half bottle of white wine from the bar. Now you are being asked to calculate the cost of food consumed. If the employee's meal was 25,500, 25,000 running francs, calculate the cost of food sold. We are given employees' meals cost, and we are asked to calculate the cost of food sold. It is very simple. So calculate the closing stock for that day. After issuing items, how was the value of their stock after issuing all those items? What was the value? That is the closing stock we are being asked. If closing stock of the previous day was 50, which is the opening stock of this day? Calculate and interpret the inventory turnover. Well, we shall calculate the closing stock of that day, and we are given the closing stock over the previous day, which is the opening stock of this day. So it is very easy to calculate the inventory turnover and also interpret it. So, kindly begging you to try this question. And see you next time when you are telling me how you found it. Well, we were still discussing about the question that we I wanted you to try, which of which you are on the, you say that if you are given employees meal cost, which is equal to 25,000, you are able to calculate the cost of food sold. Now, after getting the cost of food sold, you are able to calculate the closing stock. We are asked to calculate the closing stock. And the closing stock, that is the value of all items remained in the stock on that day. Now we are asked if the closing stock of the previous day was 50,000, calculate and interpret the cost, the inventory turnover. So how will you calculate the inventory turnover? You will take the cost of food sold divided by the inventory, average inventory. And the average inventory is the summation of course, the closing and opening stock divided by two. Thank you. Hope you will try and do them. Then you will let me know if you did it well or not. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for following. Thank you very much for joining this course. Hope to see you in the third lesson, which we'll be talking about unit three. We shall be discussing unit three, which is control process of the food and beverage operations of food and beverage. Yes, of food and beverage operations. So, see you next time. Thank you.